Hello, my dear students. Today we will solve exercise 1.2 example sums. In example 3, it is given, so how root 2 can be represented on the number line? You know, in the number line, what? Integers are there. Between 0, right side of 0 positive number, that is 1, plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, and left side of 0 negative integer, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. There. But how we will solve root 2 in this number line? That one process is there. Okay. So before going this process, I have to say something. Okay. So root 2. Root 2, how you will get root 2? That from one theorem is there. That is known as Pythagoras theorem. Okay. Pythagoras theorem. Pythagoras theorem related to right angle triangle. Okay, so at first draw one right angle triangle. You know, right angle triangle means the triangle having one angle is 90 degree. So this is a right angle triangle. This is the 90 degree. One angle is right angle. Okay, so give its name PQR. Okay. So, where you are drawing right angle triangle, PQ is known as the perpendicular height and QR is known as the base. So, write here QR base and PQ is the perpendicular height, small p. Okay, and one new term is there, that is hypotenuse. What do you mean by hypotenuse? In a right angle triangle, PQR is a right angle triangle. In a right angle triangle, the opposite side of 90 degree, this is 90 degree, opposite side, that is PR, is known as the hypotenuse. Hypotenuse. Okay. Pythagoras has given the implementation of hypotenuse. What is this? Hypotenuse equal to square root of perpendicular height square plus base square. That is P square plus B square. Okay. That is the question. If given anything, root 2, root 3, root 5, root 4, what is given? Locate, but show this in number line. So, what is given? That will be the hypotenuse. That will be the hypotenuse. So, how you will get root 2 here? Here, if you always take the perpendicular height 1, okay, P equal to 1, that means P square given, so it is 1 square means 1, okay. Your target is to get root 2, so already 1 you got, so 1 plus 1 equal to 2, so here you write 1. If you write here 1, that means base square, 1 square, so base equal to 1. So, hypotenuse equal to 1 plus 1 root 2. So, where you will take base equal to 1, perpendicular height equal to 1, that time hypotenuse will be root 2. Okay? Base equal to 1, perpendicular height equal to 1, that time hypotenuse equal to 1 square plus 1 square. 1 square, that is 1, 1 square, again 1, 1 plus 1 root 2. Okay? Now, that only I will show here on the number line. This is the number line. Okay. This is midpoint of the number line. That is 0. Okay. So, the point is, point indicates 0 value. Okay. And give its, it is 0 value and give its name O. And this is 1 written. Take its name A. This point, name of this point is A. Okay. And from O to A, from O to A, how much it is? 1 unit. From O to A, that is OA equal to 1 unit. Okay. Now draw a perpendicular line on the number line. Okay. This is the perpendicular line. Give its name AC. What you have drawn? AC perpendicular to OA. Okay. AC perpendicular to oval. That is, that means this is 90 degree angle, this is 90 degree angle. So if this is 90 degree angle, if you join OC, that means OAC is a right angle triangle. Okay, so OC will be the hypotenuse. Now only I taught you hypotenuse. So what will be the value of OC? You have taken OA equal to 1 unit, AC equal to 1 unit. Therefore, OC equal to what? OA square plus AC square. Okay, now only I taught you hypotenuse square equal to P square plus B square. Here P means AC and B means base means OA. So both are in 1 unit. So 1 square plus 1 square equal to 1 plus 1 equal to under root 2. So you got OC equal to root 2. Okay. That means this point is root 2. This point is root 2. But this is not in your number line. Okay. You have to show root 2 on the number line. This is your number line. Minus 1, 0, plus 1, plus 2. Okay. So how you will show? For this, you have to take a round dot. Okay. I am taking a round dot. Now I have taken a round dot. Okay. This is the pin of the round dot. Okay, I have taken over a sketch pen. So keep your rounded pin at the point O. Keep your rounded pin at the point O. Okay, and take OC is the radius. Take OC is the radius. Then you have to draw the arc of the circle whose O is the center and OC is the radius. Okay, this arc of the circle, this black color arc, the arc of the circle intersect the number line at the point D. Okay, at the point D. So, OC and OD both are equal. OC equal to OD because you have, now only you have drawn a circle arc having center O and OC is the radius. If OC is the radius, then OD is also the radius of the circle. Because in a circle, radius are equal to each other. Therefore, OC equal to OD equal to root D. That means this OD equal to root 2. Therefore, the point D indicates what? Root 2. This is our question. So, root 2 on the number line. We have got root 2 on the number line. So write, therefore, point D expressed root 2 on the expresses on the number line. Okay, I think you have understood. Okay, next question is, example 4 is, so how root 3 can be represented on the number line? Or question like that, locate root 3 on the number line. Okay, so to get root 3, how you will get root 3? We will do same process up to this. Okay. How we will get root 3? To get root 3, at first we will go in a right angle triangle. Okay. So, from backward, always take the perpendicular height P equal to 1. P equal to 1. And base, how much? Base need how much? 1 plus, now, you have to get root 3. So, 1 plus 2 equal to 3. But how you get 2 from B square? That means that will be root 2. Base will be root 2. So how you will get direct b equal to root 2? How? It is impossible because in a number line only integers are there. So to solve question number 4, at first how much you have solved in question number 3? That much you have to solve full. That means up to this much. Then you have to do what I am doing. Okay. Up to this much you will do. Then what you will do? Then I am showing here. That means already you have got root 2 on the number line. Okay. After that. Now. Now, OD equal to how much? Root 2. OD equal to root 2. Okay. Now, draw a perpendicular line at the point D. Name is D. E. Okay. Now draw DE perpendicular OD. Okay. DE perpendicular OD. Because we have to now this is base root 2. Okay. And this is 1. So now join. OE. Okay. That means now ODE is a right angle triangle. So from triangle ODE. Okay. Now look at that. ODE triangle. In from ODE triangle, OD is the base, DE is the height, and OE is the hypotenuse. Okay. OE is the hypotenuse. Because this time we have to get root 3. So how you get root 3? Well, base is root 2 and perpendicular height is 1. So now from the triangle OE equal to square root of OD square plus B square. Okay. OD equal to root 2 whole square and D equal to 1 square. This is root 2. You know root 2 whole square, that is 2. So 2 plus 1 equal to root 3. Now you got this hypotenuse OE. This hypotenuse equal to root 3 OE. Okay. Then next process what will be? Next process is you have to take a rounder. Okay. You have to take one rounder. Now take my rounder is very small, so it is not coming. Take O as the center and OE is the radius. O is the center. And OE is the radius. Now take O as the center and OE is the radius. So keep your rounder pin at the point O and take OE is the radius and draw the circle which intersect in your number line at the point F. At the point F. This F. Okay. That means now OE equal to OE equal to OF. OE equal to OF. Because now only you have drawn the arc of the circle. So taking OE is the radius. If OE is the radius, then O of OF also the radius. And both radius are equal. So OE equal to OF equal to root 3. That means point f is indicating root 3 on your number line. Okay. So write, therefore, f point expresses root 3 on the number line. Okay, so whatever the number is given, at first you will solve by Pythagoras theorem. What number is given, that number considered as a hypotenuse. Here root 3 given. So how you will get root 3? 3 equal to 2 plus 1. Always take perpendicular height equal to 1. So 1 plus 2 equal to 3. So base will be root 2. Okay. But remember, in a number line, root 2 is not there. So at first we have to find root 2 on the number line. Then root 2 square 2 plus 1 root 3. Then we will find root 3. Directly you can't show root 3 on the number line. So to solve the question number example 4, at first full example 3 you have to solve. Then this much what I have done here. Okay. Today up to this much, all of you practice at your home. This one. Okay. Thank you.